In July 2021, human remains were found buried on a man's property in Grain Valley, Missouri. On October 6, 2020, a 32-year-old woman went missing from Independence, Missouri, named Kenzie Renee Aubrey. She was reported to have been with two males and one female around the time she disappeared. Her family suspected something bad may have happened to her and that foul play may have been involved in Kenzie's disappearance. Kenzie had moved from Pearland, Texas to Missouri to start a new chapter in her life. Months had passed since Kenzie's disappearance and a break finally came in her missing persons case. In April 2021, a 13-year-old teenage girl who lived in a foster care home spoke to investigators and told them a 40-year-old man named Michael John Hendricks and his girlfriend 30-year-old Maggie Patience Ibarra, a prostitute, had showed her photos of Kenzie naked and bound and the chainsaw which was used to dismember her. She claimed Michael Hendricks had molested her at his home in Grain Valley, Missouri, and that he and Maggie had sex in front of her to entice her into sexual activity. The teenager told investigators that Michael confessed to choking Kenzie Aubrey and putting her body in a freezer. The teenager told police that Maggie was her foster mother and that Maggie had her try on lingerie. Then the teenager, Ibarra, and Michael Hendricks went into bed together. The teenager said Hendricks started touching her, and he moved his hand lower, rubbing her private area over underwear. The teen said her mom was also rubbing her hands and that the two adults had sexual contact with her in the bed. Later on in the visit, the child says Hendricks and Ibarra told her they wanted a sexual relationship with her. Michael told the teen it was a fantasy of his to strangle someone to death during sex. The teen said Hendricks and Ibarra initially tried disposing of Kenzie's dismembered remains by throwing parts out of his helicopter. When that didn't work, they buried the remains on Hendricks' property. Maggie Ibarra contacted 32-year-old Kenzie Aubrey off Facebook and arranged a meetup. Kenzie at the time did part-time sex work.
My name is Michael Hendricks. I'm a private pilot, and I wanted to talk a little bit about an accident I had 18 months ago. I posted a video on YouTube, and I wanted to spend a little bit of time, now that I've had quite a bit of time to process what's happened, go through some training. I wanted to talk about what happened and share my experience, what I've learned, and kind of reprocess that video, share, and hope that it can help other people avoid the mistake that I made. One of the things is it's very easy in the moment when something first happens to start shoving and saying all of the things that you think that are going through your mind when something first happens. I posted a video right after it happened, kind of trying to maybe vlog what was going on. And I think in some ways it did more damage than good.
Michael Hendricks on the surface seemed like a normal guy who was a married man with a good job as a CEO of a network management company. He had a passion for aviation and was a private rotorcraft pilot. He regularly piloted and took his friends and family on helicopter trips through Kansas City, Missouri, and through to Iowa. Michael Hendricks was living a secret life. He was cheating on his wife and seemed to want to explore his sexual deviant side with Maggie Ibarra, who called him her boss and lover. Michael met Maggie allegedly through a Narcotics Anonymous meeting. Maggie Ibarra was a past drug user and sex worker. It had also been claimed Michael met her through paying for her escort services. Maggie and Michael had known each other for about a year and a half before the incidents at Michael's Grain Valley home. On April 30th, 2021, Maggie Ibarra was arrested on charges relating to the incident involving the teenager. She had tried to get the teenager to take back what she told the police by getting someone to try to give her gifts to change her mind. Maggie also called Michael to get him to dispose of evidence from her home while she was in jail. Michael Hendricks was eventually arrested on May 16, 2021 on a Class C felony charge of third-degree child molestation with a child less than 14 years old. His wife filed for a divorce in the same month after finding out about his arrest and the details of his charges. It was later discovered the young teen had suffered sexual abuse from other males involved with Maggie Ibarra prior to her knowing Michael, and the abuse was going on for quite some time. Before Michael knew Maggie, he had other females who worked with him as a partner who had helped him in the past on other endeavors. In July 2021, the FBI helped and assisted the Independence, Missouri police to search and excavate Michael Hendricks' Grain Valley property to find the remains of the missing woman. The human remains discovered were that of 32-year-old Kenzie Aubrey, and the information investigators acquired prior to the discovery helped in identifying her from the remains found.
An update now to the story we first brought you as breaking news yesterday. Police have now ID'd the human remains found in Grain Valley.
They've determined those remains found in a yard on Buckner-Tarsney Road are 32-year-old Kenzie Aubrey. She was reported missing 9 months ago. 41 Action News reporter Sarah Plake has the latest on this case.
We have received confirmation that the body found on this property is 32-year-old Kenzie Aubrey. Her friends and family haven't seen or spoken to her since October 2020. Her friends told me it was like she fell off the face of the earth. Her friends also told me she was familiar with and associated with Mike Hendricks, the man who lives here in the property where her remains were located. Independence and Grandview police were both investigating Kenzie Aubrey's disappearance. In 2020, family feared that foul play was involved. They've been circulating her missing person flyers ever since.
Forensic anthropologists might be called upon to help confirm an identification based on comparison between those remains and some kinds of records of that person's medical records or dental records or something that were created when the person was still alive.
Jennifer Bankston is an associate professor of anthropology at Southeast Missouri State University. She's not on this case, but has experience with similar cases. She says the quick identification in Aubrey's case happened likely because detectives were already on it. Otherwise, identification takes longer.
We have been in consultation with the Jackson County Prosecutor's Office, and upon confirmation of the identity of those remains, it will be referred to their office for homicide charges.
Police haven't said what brought them to Hendricks' property in their search. However, he's facing child molestation charges involving his girlfriend, Maggie Ibarra's daughter. The child accused them of showing her pictures of a tied-up woman, saying they killed this woman and buried her. Sarah Plake, 41 Action News.
Thank you, Sarah. And you heard Sarah say the property owner and his girlfriend both face child sex charges.
Michael Hendricks and Maggie Ibarra are both currently in jail for those alleged crimes. They face several charges, including child molestation and sexual misconduct. 41 Action News just talked with the mom of 32-year-old Kenzie Aubrey. She told us she last talked with her daughter in October before she was reported missing. She said she wished the missing person case would have been taken more seriously, and she's currently working with police right now.
A week after finding Kenzie's remains, the FBI went back to the Grain Valley home and started digging in other areas of the land on the property. On August 2, 2021, a Missouri grand jury indicted 40-year-old Michael Hendricks and 30-year-old Maggie Ibarra, who were charged with killing 32-year-old Kenzie Renee Aubrey. The grand jury also indicted them on harassment, first-degree sexual misconduct, and child molestation charges, among others. In September 2021, Grandview, Missouri police investigators asked for the public's help. The detectives wanted to know if anyone had social media contact with Michael Hendricks of Grain Valley about a chest-style freezer. Police released a picture of a similar style freezer. It was bought in the spring of 2021 using an online platform such as Facebook or Craigslist. After four delays, Michael Hendricks and Maggie Ibarra's trial eventually began on July 5, 2023 at the Jackson County Courthouse in Kansas City, Missouri. On the evening of July 13, 2023, a jury found Michael Hendricks guilty of first-degree murder, harassment, attempted enticement of a child, child molestation, and sexual misconduct. A jury found Maggie Ibarra guilty of second-degree murder, harassment, attempted enticement of a child, sexual misconduct, attempted tampering with physical evidence, and 3 counts of attempted tampering with a victim. The jury found Ibarra not guilty of 2 counts of possession of child pornography and not guilty of sexual exploitation. On September 12, 2023, Michael Hendricks was sentenced to a life sentence of 30 years without the possibility of parole plus 44 and a half more years, while Maggie Ibarra was sentenced to life in prison plus 56 and a half years.